Hello friends, here in this video we will see a problem which is based on Carnot cycle. Here is the question. I'll read the question and write that in the form of data. Now it is given that a Carnot engine, so Carnot engine will work on Carnot cycle. So here the type of cycle is Carnot cycle, working between 400 degrees Celsius and 40 degrees Celsius. In Carnot cycle, the maximum and minimum temperatures are given. So I'll write down T max is equal to 400 degrees Celsius. Now if I convert it into Kelvin, I'll have to add 273. So therefore T max will be 673 Kelvin, and then the minimum temperature is 40 degrees Celsius. So this will be 40 plus 273, so minimum temperature is 313 Kelvin, and then it produces 130 kilojoule of work. So I'll write down that the work which is produced, that is work done, is equal to 130 kilojoule. Determine the engine thermal efficiency, means here we have to find out the engine thermal efficiency, and since the engine is working on Carnot cycle, since it is a Carnot engine, so the engine thermal efficiency will be Carnot efficiency. Second, the heat added, Q suffix A, how much is the heat supplied, that we have to calculate, and entropy changes during heat rejection process. So we have to find out how much is the change in entropy denoted by delta S. So now with the data available, let us try to get the solution to this problem. Now in the solution part, since the problem is on Carnot cycle, we first need to draw the Carnot cycle on PV and TS diagram. Now in Carnot cycle, the first process is isentropic compression, and that can be shown on the PV diagram with the help of a curve. So here we have process 1 to 2 as isentropic compression. Next, process 2 to 3 is isothermal heat addition. So again, isothermal lines on PV diagram, it will be a curve from 2 to 3. Then the next process 3 to 4 is isentropic expansion, like here it was isentropic compression. Now we have isentropic expansion, again following a curve. From 3 to 4. And at last we have the heat rejection process, which is again at isothermal heat rejection process, that is at constant temperature. So here I have drawn the PV diagram for Carnot cycle, and next I can draw it on TS diagram as well. The first process is isentropic compression. So isentropic compression is governed by the law PV raised to gamma is equal to constant, and it means that the entropy remains constant during 1 to 2, and as we see at point number 1 the volume is more, at point 2 the volume is less. So by the reduction in volume we are getting the increase in pressure, that is pressure increases from point 1 to point 2. So here this is isentropic compression, it can be shown on the TS diagram with the help of a vertical line. Process 1 to 2 is isentropic compression, entropy remains constant. So S1 is equal to S2. Then process 2 to 3 is isothermal heat addition, and isothermal lines, it follows the law PV is equal to constant, that is the temperature remains constant here. So this heat addition process is isothermal, so the temperature remains constant from point 2 to 3, that is T2 is equal to T3. Then 3 to 4 is again isentropic expansion, like here it was for 1 to 2 isentropic compression, for 3 to 4 it is isentropic expansion, PV raised to gamma is equal to constant. So again isentropic expansion can be shown by a vertical line. So from 3 to 4 the entropy remains constant, S3 is equal to S4, and here we have the expansion process in which the entropy remains constant but there is drop in temperature from point 3 to point 4. Next, from 4 to 1 it is the heat rejection process, which is at constant temperature, or we can say isothermal heat rejection, PV is equal to constant. So here as we see the temperature of point 1 and 4, they are same, so T1 is equal to T4, that is the heat rejection process. So I can mark all the processes on this diagram, that from 1 to 2 it is compression, so work is done onto the system during the compression process. During 2 to 3 there is heat addition into the system, so Q suffix A. From 3 to 4 there is isentropic expansion, so work is done, or we are getting the work output during expansion process. And 4 to 1 is the heat rejection process, which is Q suffix R. Now this is the Carnot cycle which we have. If we look at the question, the first thing is we have to find out Carnot efficiency. Now I'll write down that the first thing is calculation of Carnot efficiency. I'll write down, since Carnot efficiency is given by efficiency of Carnot engine is equal to maximum temperature minus minimum temperature upon maximum temperature. And if we look into the diagram, I can say that T2 is the maximum temperature. It is equal to T3, so we can write either T2 or T3. Then T1 is the minimum temperature, so minus T1, or even if I want I can write it as T4 because both are same, and Tmax is T2. So here is the formula to calculate the efficiency of Carnot cycle. Next I'll go on putting the values which are given in the problem. So therefore efficiency of Carnot cycle is equal to, now the maximum temperature Tmax, it is given in the problem as 673 and Tmin is 313. So I'll put the values that efficiency of Carnot cycle is maximum temperature 673 minus minimum temperature 313 divided by the maximum temperature, which is 673. So after this, when I am calculating this, I'll get my answer as 0.5349, or therefore I can say that Carnot efficiency is equal to, I have to multiply it by 100, so it becomes 53.49%. So this is the first answer for us. So now once we have calculated the Carnot efficiency, the next thing is we have to find out how much is the heat added, that is heat supplied during the isothermal heat addition process. So the next thing is calculation of heat added. So for this, again I am using the concept of Carnot efficiency, that since efficiency of Carnot cycle, it can also be written as previously we have written that in the form of temperatures. Now I can write them in the form of output and output by input. So output is the work which we are getting, that is the work done, and input is the heat which is added. So I can use this concept to calculate the heat added into the system. So therefore we require QA value. So here I'll shift QA on one side, so it will be work done upon the efficiency of Carnot cycle. Now I'll put the values. Work done, it is given in the data, it is 130 kilojoule. So 130 divided by Carnot efficiency, I am going to write the value in the form of number, which is 0.5349. So 0.5349. So ultimately my answer is 243.04 kilojoule. So this much is the heat which is added into the system, and this will be my second answer. So now it is clear that in order to get the work output of 130 kilojoule, we need to give the heat supply of 243.04 kilojoule. That I can explain it here, that here we are getting the work output, and it is given in the problem that the work output is 130 kilojoule, and for that, receiving that 130 kilojoule, we need to supply a heat of 243.04 kilojoule. Next, the third question is to calculate the entropy during the heat rejection process, which is the change in entropy. So I'll write down that calculation of change in entropy during the heat rejection process. Now, how to calculate the change in entropy during the heat rejection process? First is we need to find out how much is the heat rejected. So for that, I can say that since the work done is equal to amount of heat added minus the amount of heat rejected. That is the concept, that from the heat supplied, if we subtract the heat rejected, we are going to get how much is the work which is produced. So therefore, if we want heat rejected, I'll shift it onto the left hand side, and work done will go on right hand side. So therefore, heat rejected will become QA minus work done. So putting the values, QR will be, now heat added was 243.04 minus work done, it was 130. So therefore heat rejected was found to be 113.04 kilojoule. Now after finding the heat rejected, we need to know how much is the change in entropy. So I'll write down, therefore change in entropy is given by delta S is equal to, and since I'm finding the change in entropy during the heat rejection process, so change in entropy is given by the heat rejected upon the temperature at which the heat is rejected, and that temperature is, it is the minimum temperature. If I can explain it onto the TS diagram, we can see that the heat is rejected at T1 is equal to T4, and T1 is equal to T4, they represent minimum temperature. whereas heat was added at maximum temperature Tmax. So here heat is rejected at Tmin. So in the denominator I'll get Tmin. So this is the formula to calculate the change in entropy. Next, therefore, I'll find out delta S during the heat rejection process. So delta S will be equal to heat rejected is 113.04 upon the minimum temperature, and minimum temperature is given in the problem, that is 313 Kelvin. So 313, therefore delta S will come out to be 0.3611, that is the answer we are getting, and the unit is kilojoule per Kelvin, and this will be the third answer for us. So here if we see in the question, we were having three unknowns, that is we need to calculate the engine thermal efficiency, which was Carnot efficiency, and that Carnot efficiency was found to be 53.49%. So this was the first answer. Next, second thing was the heat added, and that heat added QA, it was found to be 243.04 kilojoule, the second answer. And at last the third question was to calculate the entropy changes during heat rejection process, that was delta S, and it was found to be 0.3611 kilojoule per Kelvin. And with this we complete the problem.